Hey friends, this is about bubbles. I bet a lot of people have bubbles out there, and it's a really fun thing to do when you're at home and maybe when you're bored. You can do it outside, you could do it inside usually, but these are great because they're spill proof. Probably a lot of you have them. So we're going to sing a song about bubbles and popping them. Ready? Can you pop the bubbles, the bubbles, the bubbles? Can you pop the bubbles? Pop them with your finger. Pop, pop, pop. I did it. How about, can you pop the bubbles, the bubbles, the bubbles? Can you pop the bubbles? Pop them with your nose. Pop. That's harder. It's harder to do. How about this one? Can you pop the bubbles, the bubbles, the bubbles? Can you pop the bubbles? Pop them with your elbow. Pop! Or your arm. Yeah, you can use all kinds of things to pop bubbles. Let's see if I can do it with my knee. Can you pop the bubbles with your knee? Let's see. Pop! I did it! Yeah, this is obviously simpler for little people. Parents, I'm going to put in the video, I'm putting a link or a recipe for how to make bubbles at home if you don't have bubbles. It's pretty easy, and sometimes you can use glycerin, sometimes not, but I'm going to put one on there that gives you some options. And bubble play is just really good for little kids. Just the blowing part, it is good for their oral motor muscles, and the blowing is good, the formation, the popping, that's good fine motor. It's body identification. You can do head, nose, whatever. And then the pop, those kinds of words are really good for their speech. So I just encourage bubble play. It's really good, especially for the little ones or any kids that are having trouble with speech. But that's just a simple song. You don't have to sing that, but I just thought I'd give you some ideas. But I'm going to post also, like I said, a description of how to make some bubbles at home in case you don't have any. So hope you guys enjoyed.